After burning for more than 30 hours, the rig sank around lunchtime today. There are now new concerns about leaking oil and possible damage to the environment. WDSU News reporter Randy Russo is on your side with what's being done to prevent the oil from spreading. Randy?
Well, Norman, tonight there is a crude oil slick basically across the Gulf surface. The Department of Environmental Quality tells me it's running about 15 miles from where the rig sank, closing in towards Mississippi. But the question that has many people concerned, will even more oil leak out? With a rainbow sheen treading on Gulf waters, questions are now surfacing as to whether or not thousands of gallons of more crude oil could be released.
We don't know what's going on below the surface of the water. We have a remotely operated vehicle subsurface that's going to determine what is going on.
Since the Deepwater Horizon rig sank Thursday, the U.S. Coast Guard has also dispatched over 30 spill response boats and put out 1 million miles of boom to stop any oil from spreading.
The issue is, can we stop the flow of oil? Is there oil coming up from the borehole? If so, how much is it? How can we stop it?
The rig had drilled over 18,000 feet. The worst case scenario, 336,000 gallons of crude oil could be released from the well per day. But the initial spill is considered relatively small by the Coast Guard.
What is this spill going to do for our fisheries? It's absolutely devastating.
Ann Ross with the Bucket Brigade disagrees, saying this big blaze is a way of shining a light on an ongoing problem.
Rigs in the Gulf since 2001 have averaged 95 fires a year, have averaged 150 worker injuries every year, and there have been an average since 2001 of 7 worker deaths every year.
Ralph says this accident is just another example of how environmental protection and the economy should work hand in hand. Other Gulf states like Alabama and Mississippi have been notified of a potential threat to their shorelines, but so far with the oil 40 miles off the coastline, many say this is just a wait-and-see situation.
We can project where that oil is going to impact based on weather conditions, you know, wind conditions, things like that. We have no oil impacting shoreline at this time.
And Norman, the DEQ tells me that overnight tonight, the Coast Guard will be spraying a dispersant over the oil, which is going to cause it to then break up and sink. They say the offshore fishing species out there, they may be affected, as well as some commercial or recreational boating until all this oil is cleaned up.
All right, Randy, a big task ahead, no doubt. The Coast Guard says they have pre-planned staging areas for environmentally sensitive areas like estuaries, wildlife refuges, and Gulf Coast communities in case the oil does travel to shore.